life, love, and pop culture.
Hi, I'm Danielle Delgado.
And I'm Joshua Rush, and you're watching Life, Love, and Pop Culture.
How are you, Joshua?
I'm good. I'm doing pretty great. How are you?
Good. Look how adorable he is. I gotta say, okay, I don't know if I should tell you this because I'm a little older, but I actually watched the show and I really love it.
There's no shame. There's no shame in that. Put it there, guys. There is no shame in watching Andy Mack as a person outside of the target demographic. So many people do. I've been seeing Instagram posts from like 20, 30 year olds who have been like loving the show, and it's awesome. It like spans generations. Mm-hmm. It's cool.
Yeah. I think this show is like so different from any other Disney show out there, right?
Definitely, yeah. I think it kind of straddles the line, but it also really sticks to those core Disney values, which makes it really special. It makes it isolated and special, but it also is still something that's very familiar when you're watching Disney Channel and you're like, yeah.
What kind of intrigued you about your role of Cyrus?
I think working with Terry Minsky was really the thing that really got me excited about going and being Cyrus. She's this incredible writer, and I love Lizzie McGuire, as I know so many people have. So the opportunity to work with Terry Minsky, and I mean, I had read the first episode, and just reading the first episode, I was like, what? Just totally mind blown. So I mean, it was the combination of her and the script that really brought me to Cyrus and got me really intrigued.
So for people that haven't seen Andy Mack, tell them a little bit about the show.
Okay, sure. Andy Mack is a show about this girl who gets her life completely flipped upside down when her sister comes home and reveals to her that she's not actually her sister, she's her mother. It's awesome. And I play Cyrus, who is one of her Andy, who's the main character's two best friends, along with Buffy, played by Sophia Wiley. And it's really a show about her and her figuring out her life after this complete revelation. It's really fun.
I feel like your character Cyrus has a secret, and I'm hoping we're gonna find out this secret.
You might.
Because you guys are coming back for a second season, right?
We are coming back for a second season. I'm definitely really excited about it. I know plenty of secrets, but unfortunately, I can't tell you.
He's holding out on me.
I'm holding out on her.
That's not nice. I thought we just...
I know. I'm sorry. We just... But I mean, like, when you sign an NDA, you gotta keep that NDA. You know what I'm saying?
I know.
I'll be happy to talk about whatever secrets come out the minute that they come out.
You're gonna come
but
to
me until, first. I'll come right to you. Y'all hear it here first.
You heard it. He said he's gonna come to me first, so I'm gonna hold you to that.
Yeah.
What are you hoping happens in season two?
I'm hoping, and I think there is going to be a lot more of Cyrus really finding himself, and we're gonna find out more of, I really wanna find out more about Cyrus's backstory. That's something that has been like bugging me the whole time, like from episode one. I want a backstory episode on Buffy and Cyrus. Now, I don't know if we'll actually end up getting a backstory episode. That's up to Terry. Please. But I mean, if we do, I think that'd be really, really cool, really interesting to get.
Yeah, there was an episode where you got a text message, and it said you are girly.
Yeah.
And it kind of affected your character because you were trying to change to be somebody else, right?
Definitely.
So did you ever have a moment where you felt like you had to be somebody else?
Definitely. I think kind of, especially in this business, you're always expected to be a little adult, really. Like, especially when you're out and you're on the red carpet and things like that, or even interviews like this, you know, you're expected to be an adult. I'm 15 years old. I want to go out and hang out with my friends and stuff, but I have to kind of be both. So I definitely know the struggle of needing to be someone else and putting on a mask for different people. I definitely know that struggle, and I've been able to work that out with myself, but it's definitely something that I know a lot of people struggle with.
I think you've had a good, like an amazing career, and you're so young, so I know that you'll continue to have a great career, but what do you want people to remember you for?
I want to be remembered that I was never afraid to be myself. that I had a good sense of style, definitely. No, but I want to be remembered as a person who was never afraid to be themselves, because I think especially today with social media and how everyone is trying to be someone else, mm-hmm. you always should be able to be yourself, even if it's a sort of more mature, a little more collected version of yourself. You should never be afraid to be yourself. Mm-hmm. I'd like to be remembered as a person who was never afraid to be himself.
Life, love, and pop culture.
Okay, go.
You're right. Hi, I'm Danielle Delgado.
And I'm Joshua Rush, and you're watching Life, Love, and Pop Culture.
I did it wrong.
If you enjoyed my interview, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and don't forget to look out for new videos every Wednesday.